Donald Trump has sealed his presidential victory. He won the Electoral College vote today as expected. Good evening, I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Trump received all 29 electoral votes in Florida. There was mounting pressure for electors to break their pledge and go with Hillary Clinton, who won the popular vote. NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias talked with electors feeling the heat, Dave.
Yeah, two Southwest Florida electors tell me that they were flooded with letters urging them to vote for Hillary Clinton. But under Florida law, they took an oath to uphold the winning candidate.
I feel like my vote didn't count this year.
Janet DeJesus, like many, is upset that Hillary Clinton got nearly 2.9 million more votes than Donald Trump, yet Trump won the election.
And things need to be changed, and one of those things could be the Electoral College.
Her friend Sue McQuaid disagrees.
Stop all the nonsense and let's move on. It's about the country and what we can do for the country and getting everybody back together.
Try telling that to the dozens of protesters today in Tallahassee. Their message to electors, vote Clinton instead.
It's a little disappointing that they're so vigorously trying to change the course of the election.
She's talking specifically about the thousands of letters that she and fellow representative elector Ray Rodriguez got.
I probably received 5,000 contacts from people who have encouraged me to not vote for Donald Trump.
He came home to bags of mail like this. Others were stacked on his desk. Many electors say their mailboxes were stuffed with anti-Trump mail from states like California and New York.
Essentially, they're asking me to ignore the voters of Florida and instead cast my ballot for the person that won their state.
Now, electors like State Senator Elizabeth Beniquisto are required to sign a pledge saying they will vote for the popular candidate in Florida.
Each of the 29 electors did just that, leaving voters like Sue with hope the country will accept the outcome.
It's divided and we need to stop that and get all back together.
Now, it appears there were only two faithless electors who didn't vote for Trump. Now, one of them was in Maine. He voted for Bernie Sanders, but then changed to Hillary Clinton. And a Texas elector voted for Ohio Governor John Kasich. Hawaii is the last state to vote. That happens tonight at 7 o'clock. Live in the studio, Dave Elias, NBC2.